This motherfucker, Ngannou, man, I've been calling his fights for a while. When that guy walks into the cage, it sounds different.
He's huge. Did you see his hand next to Stan's?
Yeah, it's 256. Dude, he makes me look like a little tiny person he can keep in his pocket.
He's huge, man. And Arlovsky's not small.
Yeah. No. He's a big dude. No. And he's just solid as a rock, man.
He's French, yeah?
Yes. He's French
by
from
way
Nigeria.
Of the Congo. Oh, Nigeria.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And he's just a super athlete, man.
They think he's the next striker. The next big thing.
Well, you know, we've yet to see him against a really good wrestler. I don't say anybody's the next big thing until they go with Kane. You got to go with Kane, a healthy Kane.
That pressure.
Well, there's a couple guys. You see what he did to Travis. You see what he did to Rothwell. He just does shit.
He gets his face in your chest and just.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, he gets past all your bullshit and then puts it to you with a pace that you just can't take. Mm-hmm. The real question with Kane is, can he still do that? He's had so many injuries. Yeah. They pulled him off of his last fight because he's got stenosis, so his fucking spinal column is shrinking, and they have to open him up and
so you know,
carve
you know
a path
you know,
through the nerves.
It's Stipe versus JDS now.
That is what the next fight is.
Stipe's legit. We just gave away this fight. It's real.
Why?
No, you don't.
What, because of Stipe?
No,
JDS?
Don't say it. You'd like to see him fight.
When necessary.
Yeah.
Only in the that is the correct answer.
It's only one of them. Man, Arlovsky's in the 47. Isn't that crazy?
He's got a lot of money.
In MMA years,
you're towards.
That's crazy. Because in boxing,
he's kind of right there.
But he's running at him. He's got punches too.
When he comes in behind that double right hand all the time, you see it coming back. Yeah, he is very much already much improved. You know that's coming. Spooky. Yikes. There was an overhand. Arlovsky with the overhand right. He's just twice.
The uppercut got him too. The uppercut's what did him in.
Read Arlovsky's overhand right. As soon as that overhand right is there, this is done.
He
wants to be
the guy to tell him to stop with the leg movement.
So watch when we see the replay. Arlovsky's overhead right.
He called it too. He said he's gonna knock him out in the first round.
Is that part of
a
prediction?
I'm a lot more impressed even than last time.
It is for Travis Brown. I mean, you gotta think Arlovsky just knocked out Travis Brown a couple of fights ago.
He's lost his last three.
Yeah. He walks the right hand off of Arlovsky. Southpaw like that.
It's almost like a check.
Yeah.
Hook, right?
You draw, slide out. It's a head position is key, and then you come back to the top.
Isn't
that was by design.
It's so important that a referee knows
how to do this
because no one's concerned about that stoppage.
No. Nope.
But in other fights, that would have been a stoppage where people went, what the fuck? He only took a couple shots when he's down. Give him a chance to recover.
Yeah, not with that monster.
Yeah, with Ngannou, you're like, no, that good. That's good. It's good.
No,
good.
He's probably heard it. Yeah, he can probably hear the impact from his.
Oh, yeah.
I would like to see him fight like a Rothwell, where that shot doesn't put him down. He just keeps coming for a little
weird,
bit.
Or maybe it puts squared up all the time and stuff.
Maybe it does. We don't know. Because he's beat up basically cans. Then he gave him Arlovsky, right? And just murked Arlovsky.
He looked good, though, here now.
Well, do you remember when Ben Rothwell fought Arlovsky and Arlovsky fucked him up?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that was Arlovsky when he was in his, well, not even in his prime. He was a little slipped.
Affliction.
By then. Yeah,
right?
It was the affliction days. Yeah. It was a little past his prime.
Yeah.
You know, Arlovsky's prime was when he was in his 20s.
Brother, he went on a run in the UFC, though.
Okay,
he's one fight away from a heavyweight title.
Yeah,
2 years ago.
2 years ago. But do you remember when he was young? Remember when he starched Paul Bunton
with
one punch?
He's my favorite.
He had a right hand that was like a piston, dude. And it's almost like now you can see the wear and tear on his shoulders when he's throwing punches.
Stiff.
Like he throws punches differently now. Back then, everything was just laser beam straight.